There are many common points on my presentation, what Kai already has said, but still, I hope that this is more investor eyes. This has looked more investor eyes. So, it is nice to have so much persons here on this room to hear this presentation, and I will tell Finnish side of this story if Kai has a Swedish side. And I would like first to thank Jani Impola, Aleksi Salo, and Pekka Nurmi, who has contributed to this presentation, and Heikki Bauert here, who has invited me here. We are lucky that these colors are visible here. So this beautiful aurora borealis sign on the sky of top of Kevitsa mine in northern Finland. Yes. So, and yes, and I'm like it was presented, I'm Pasi Heino, and heading one of the GTK's units, ore and industrial minerals, and we are as a total of or a little bit over 400 people in GTK, and we are a government research organization. And you can meet our personnel in our offices, Espoo, Kuopio, Kokkola, and Rovaniemi, and then we are having this special office located in Outokumpu, where we are having our pilot beneficiation plant with mineralogical and bench scale lab services. And also we have this Loppi drill core depository, like Swedish has own kind. Then we go back to the topic and start the story, how to attract investors. We can ask which, why, how, and when some location is attractive. It is tricky question, and there is not one explanation, and we need to remember that everything is also time dependable, so means when. I hope that during the presentation, we think what reasons fits under these questions, and what is the most important that we get also answers to these questions. If not, I hope that we have a few minutes after the presentation to have more questions. One of the most important thing is that there are commodities needed in the area. Best is that there are wide variety of commodities. When having wide variety of commodities, you have a strength base. When world economy and political atmospheres changes, it's critical. And like we all know, everything changes all the time. Now we have battery hype because mobilization transformation, and I will come back to that a little bit more later on. Here is first a little bit background for these commodities, what we have. And we are located in top of Europe on many ways. Our geology provides suitable bedrock to have successful prospection with many commodities like base metals, gold, platinum, industrial minerals, high-techs, and even diamonds. And what helps us is long mining tradition. It proves historically successful mining operations and gives high guarantee that today's prospectors will find something new. Undiscovered deposits are just waiting for you. This is something what we can say to the investors. Well, there is also some gray colored map on the behind, but maybe we can imagine Fennoscandia there. So to show a wide variety of different commodities, we have here the map showing our current tenements and exploration permit areas. I think that Terho from Finnish Mining Authority will show a little more carefully to Finland here on this side. And like you can see, the Fennoscandia is quite nicely covered with these tenements. So there is very lot. There are a lot of activities in here. When we look over Finland, as it already mentioned, we are having very strong mining cluster here. And why is that? If we look Finland, we see that it's covered from north to south. The mining activities, different commodities, but among those we have smelters, refineries, and mining technology all in one package in Finland. In example, 13% of world cobalt is refined in Finland, and it is highly notable that that huge part of global mining tech comes from Nordic countries, where Finland has strong footprint. I believe that quite many of you are familiar with Outotec, Metso, Normet, and Sandvik. Even Sandvik is a more Swedish company, but we also feel that Sandvik is like Finnish company also. Thank you. So, going to the attractiveness, how others sees our attractiveness. As one KPI, we can use Fraser Institute's annual survey. And let's see how Finland is situated in this survey. If we look to years 2017, Finland were on top of these graphs. Several sub-survey parts in this survey were also on top. Finland were also on top of 5 or top of 10. And we managed to have this number one position on that year. Highly appreciated SEO databases were specially pointed out. Then, only 1 year later on, 2018, if we look the same graphs, what has happened? You can ask. I was asking also. Position has dropped heavily. We are on level 17 regarding investment attractiveness and number 19 in geo databases. Geological databases, availability of labor and skilled labor was getting low points. Also, mineral potential best practices has went down a lot. In this 2018, last year. We have done some analyzing about the reasons, and one relating to the geo databases. The reasons for that is that one key data delivery base, GTK's internet platform, starts to be outdated, and that needs to be upgraded to 2020 level. 3D modeling need to be integrated more closely to our daily work and build a platform to deliver 3D, even 4D data. We are too much ticked on 2D data still. Hyperspectral data, like Kai showed in some pictures, is highly appreciated in modern exploration. And in Finland, we are currently not delivering that. So that was one example. Your databases. Lot of things to do. And we need to be aware all the time where the world is going. We need to think what are the investors' needs. That's very important. Well, we can be somehow happy still. We are number one in Europe. But competition from investors is extremely tough, and there are many heading the pole position. Very equal game. Let's still look more closely at these geo databases, because it's somehow the base for everything. It really is one key element to promote the area and show what is the potential to find something new. Some issues are essential. We need different types of high resolution airborne geophysics in various scales, ground geophysics, digital bedrock maps, thematic map, maps and interpreted data. And as I said earlier, we should include hyperspectral data here in the future. Important to have all in internet distribution. And always remember to promote the place where you can find the data. If you have the data but no one knows where it is, it's not useful. So there are some text on those green balloons, but not much can be seen, but hopefully I can explain something. So we have in Finland strongly committed to systematic development of mining industry, especially a mineral policy, which is the aim of the Ministry of Economic Affairs and Employment in Finland, that we secure Finland's raw material supply and ensure sustainable use of national resources, international competitiveness, responsible use of natural resources, and vitality of Finnish regions. And also, when this kind of mineral policy is created, it helps to promote research and production of raw materials for the needs of the society and helps to ensure correct management of resources, taking into account the opportunities generated by the circular economy, which is in everyone's lips nowadays. Where we are in 2018, we can ask, it's the uppermost balloon there. We are now taking this future mobility transform to our focus area, and there comes this battery hype in. Kai was having several slides regarding on this social acceptance. It is a vital starting point from exploration to the mining operations. And one thing is that we have established in Finland is network for sustainable mining. Canada has been a role model for this, and our model is developed from this Canadian network to fit it in Finnish purposes. It is well described in this video, which you can find from YouTube. I won't show it now. 5 minutes video for sustainable mining networking. I believe that it's good to see. Like we saw a few examples from Sweden, I will show a few examples from Finland. There are some active exploration projects and major mines, what I show to you. This gives a perspective what is currently ongoing. These seven mines mentioned in this table are producing the most of the raw materials in Finland. And these sevens are having the main part of Finnish mining tons. We have here gold, chromium, copper, zinc, nickel, and phosphate. What comes to the exploration highlights, in this table shows some of the most important findings, where we can say that this Sakatti polymetallic deposit can be said to be the number of discovery in decades. That will partly answer the questions where we can have our battery metals in the future. And also we can see from this table that the base metals, gold and graphite, has been in great interest recently. What comes to the development highlights, we can say that we have several projects proceeding strongly. A few words about those can be said now here. So that chemi-chromium mine expansion is ongoing. Terrafame's nickel cobalt sulfate battery chemical plant will be built. Kittilä gold mine is building a shaft to 1,000 meter level and on the same time having mill throughput expansion, as well as Kevitsa mine is having production expansion. In Siilinjärvi phosphate mine, life of mine expansion project is ongoing, and in Suhanko, platinum palladium project is going to the feasibility phase. So a lot of actions ongoing. So something what answers to question what and when. We are now living in the center of this battery hype, like it was said. We can say we are on the middle of batterization. When having this kind of hype, investors are looking to find the possibilities for cobalt, lithium, graphite, nickel and copper. And Finland has right type of targets to attract investors regarding on these. One important thing is that we are more aware and interested where our commodities are coming from. And their European own source is highly interesting from investors' eyes. Shortly, a little bit background for this battery hype to explain why. As you all have noticed, the battery minerals are the hot topic, and everyone are haunting on these special minerals or metals regarding on this. The future ahead of us is unknown, but it seems that this battery boom is here to stay for a long time. And the amount of EVs needs to grow from 2016, at least it is in some forecasts said that we should have in 2030 about 200 million EVs when it was 0.2 million in 2016. It means 100 times more. And forecast for materials and metals demand from lithium-ion battery packs in passenger EVs is shown in this graph, and this shows that we certainly are growing 35 times in demand within this 10 years period, which is a huge, huge increase. So to investors, we can say, we can show that, hey, strong potential to these commodities, multiple projects on different phases proves that it is worth to explore more. They have found something. Maybe we can find two. We can say that it's our time gold rush effect. And also what we can show from Finland to the investors that there are several geological environments to find cobalt. These are proven environments. And the same is with lithium. High potential is still left. There are huge areas where we can have these lithium targets. And if we go to the graphite, it's a little bit harder because there hasn't been so high intense exploration and mining relating to that. But potential is still proven. And a couple of words about ongoing battery operations. These are attracting also new investors when exploration has really turned active mining operations. Terrafame's Talvivaara deposit, nickel, zinc, copper and cobalt. In 2018, there were a nice production, 27 kilotons nickel, 62 kilotons zinc. And it was a 31% increase if we compare it to year 2017. And like it was said earlier, it has been decided to build a battery, a great nickel cobalt sulfate plant on the site. What comes to the lithium? Very promising developing phase project ongoing. Spodumene hosted deposit, 13 years mine life planned, and the starting year 2021. Lithium potential is proved to other investors. Few words about what CTK is doing, and we are doing our own part, at least try to do our own part to attract investors to Finland. Currently, we are deeply inside this battery hype. we have established battery mineral project. This is mineral potential mapping, and we are also developing exploration techniques on the same way. Hyperspectral solutions is one thing. We have noticed that it is needed. And main purpose is that we can raise new potential areas to attract investors in Finland. That's the one main thing. What we do in this year with this project is data collection and evaluation. We look countrywide cobalt and graphite potential, and this helps investors and gives stronger backbone to explore these commodities from right locations. And sharing data is important also here. Don't keep it under the table. And one thing is Lehmann samples. Someone are asking, what are those? What is the Lehmann sample? It means that anyone can pick the rock sample from the ground and send it to the CTK to further studies. We have had this Lehmann sample collection part of our operations from the beginning of the CTK. Ordinary people who walk in the forest and pick berries and mushrooms are important part when finding something new. Yes, I'm coming to that later on. Most of the Finnish mines are based on Lehmann samples. We have developed the process, and we are launching a mobile application to help this procedure, so that you will get important information via this application, and coordinates to your sample is easy to save, and you have the almost real-time possibility to ask from our geologists, is this sample which I found so interesting that I will send it to you. We have also cash prizes, and to have younger senders also among this competition, like you noticed, there's 60 plus, we established also young senders category for this pricing. We also believe that this mobile application will be interesting for young senders and also activates activity in nature. Lehmann sample database is also freely available from internet. And this is the picture how we all have promote Finland and Fennoscandia in different exhibitions and talks, in so that you can see that in this picture it's easily so that we have all that makes investors happy. We can say that Finland is highly interesting because its potential and geodata in place, but we need to remember that also our infrastructure is already in place and just waits for future mining operations, and we are very stable and secure locations for future mining business. So secure your investments is a key word. So let's make a final summary for this all. First, we can look this again. Which, why, how, and when some location is attractive. So this is the some kind of summary, let's say. So what is needed? So investors need something to attract. You need to have a strong commodity portfolio. Several different kind of metals. Depends on economical and need balance, of course. Important that what you have is in attractive format and everything is transparent. Data need to be shared via internet and known distribution channels. Promote those channels. Law and regulation needs to be steady, attractive and transparent. All information important to pack in easy format and distribute via internet. Country needs to have attractive mineral policy. And on many phases I have said this, that this promotion is highly important. So that investors knows what you have. exhibitions like PDAC in Canada, Toronto, Minds and Money, several places in the world. Social media plus social selling is important. And social acceptance is on level which investors accept. Sustainable network in mining is example how it works in what is done in Finland and Canada. Everything needs to be done so that the need of investors has been taken care and promotion is essential. So, please explore Finland. Thank you. It was a pleasure to give this presentation.
Thank you, Pasi. How popular this layman way is? How many samples you get through the year?
Several thousands.
Several thousands?
Yes.
And how many people put it all together?
Several hundreds. Layman sample centers, there we are having several hundreds, but we are having only two people mainly in CTK who are dealing with those samples. So.
Okay.
Yeah. Full workload.
Yeah. Very good example to how to work with society.
Yep. It is.
In different quality connection with.
Yep.
Jaa, kas keegi soovib küsida veel ka midagi? Jaa, palun, Kai.
Just a comment. We have also had that layman project in Sweden years back. Now we didn't have any funding, so we didn't do that. But one of the brilliant things with the layman project is that these are not geologists, so they don't understand that it is impossible to find something interesting where they are. So they tend to do that. They find interesting stuff that all geologists know. There should be nothing.
Yeah, that's very true.
Lihtsalt väike kõrvalepõige, et tõesti olime ühte Tartu Ülikooliga seotud saatesari ettevalmistamas ja käisime sellega seoses kolmapäeval Tartu Ülikooli muuseumis, loodusmuuseumis. Ja nemad saata, seal kohtusime prouaga, kes peab siis, noh, tõenäoliselt paljud teist on nemaga kohtunud, nime ei mäleta praegu, aga kes ütles, et aastas umbes 20, 30, 40 kivi või kivipilti talle saadetakse ja küsitakse, et mis see on. Nii et selles mõttes töötab see layman süsteem mõnes mõttes ka nagu Eestis. Ehkki seda ei juhi siis nagu sektor, vaid ülikool. Aitäh! Suur tänu! Thank you!
Yes, thank you!